bi-weekly tarot reading until August 11th, just for this time, guys. So let's get started. Let me start with general type of a reading for the next 2 weeks, and then, guys, I will proceed with love tarot reading. Whether you are man or woman, guys, stay tuned. I think it's going to be fun. Okay, so first general type of a reading, and the very first what the heck, guys, this is you. Pisces, this is you, no doubt about it. So you are obviously focused on you. And why not? So guys, this is you, you know. So let me see, home and family matters now probably are in your focus. You, your life, what you want, your expectations, plans, you know, all these type of things, you know. So you know, sit down, relax, you know, meditate, you know, a little bit what you want to achieve after probably August 11, because guys, I know from astrology that your ruler Jupiter will be in a retrograde phase until August 11th. So guys, you know, sit down, you know, and think, you know, what you want to change in general with your life. Some of you think only of love, some of you are very ambitious, very ambitious. Some of you think only of you, some of you are very focused on what you have. But guys, you know, some of you are focused on what is still kind of, you know, missing in your life. Okay, so this is like a mixture. So, but this is not bad, guys, you know. You can be a little bit, you know, sensitive in the next, you know, 2 weeks. Because if you're only focused on what is missing, guys, you are missing the point. Nobody said that life is easy. But also, guys, you know, you need to be concentrated mostly on you. I think that so many people are using you, you know, your time, your energy, knowledge, money, guys, you know, whatever. So you need to understand that you must be first and the most important figure in your life. Guys, I think this is it, you know. I think that you really should be focused on you. Some of you maybe have, like, you know, some health, you know, issues, and, you know, this tarot card is saying, you know, lay down, sit down, and honey, just pause. Allow yourself to pause. Okay, the very next tarot card for general type of a reading, Two Pentacles. Money on your mind, thinking about a next step. Indecisiveness could be connected with love, not only with your family, also could be connected with love. Now, you are thinking about something, and something very important, so you still do not know, you know, what to make of it, you know, how to feel about, in particular, you know, some situation. One day your energy is like on a very high, and another, or in a couple of hours, or basically next day, your energy, your self-esteem is like very, very slow. Honey, you are just swinging, you know, backwards and onwards, because you do not know how to act upon one in particular situation. Guys, for some of you, this could be about job, could be about education, could be about some money. Are you going to have enough money to supply your family, or maybe you want to buy something only for you? So guys, in general, okay, I will talk about love reading in a couple of minutes, but this indecisiveness type of tarot card also, guys, you know, could talk that you have someone on your mind and you do not know, you know, your partner, or maybe someone that you fancy, you know, is this person, and how much, how deep this person is into you, meaning how deep this person is serious about you. So you have a second thought, you are swinging, because kind of you think that your whole life depends on this person and this situation. In connection with your job also, guys, there is important, you know, decision in front of you, but don't rush. Remember my words, you know, even I said until middle of August, you know, I do not need to rush. And guys, this is exactly what it is. Hopefully the third tarot card will explain what is really going on and how come you have so many second thoughts, why you are swinging Five of Pentacles. Okay, so it is in connection with your job. You have this fear, you know, what if I lose my job? Guys, don't do that, okay? Because God is watching you. Use your powerful intuition and simply make another plan. But, you know, sometimes, you know, this deprivation and this, you know, depression will go away. But guys, kind of, how can I explain that? You know, there is a shadow, like a big gray cloud above, you know, your head, thinking, you know, my bad financial situation will never change for better. So what can I do for that, you know? And you are blaming, you are constantly putting the blame on yourself. Guys, can I remind you, every single day, this is like a, almost like a million people, or okay, maybe I do exaggerate, but thousands of people are losing job every single day. I'm not saying you will, all I'm saying, try to lose, you know, this fear, that kind of this balance inside of your love and life, and especially when it comes to money, is kind of, you know, destroyed. This is, guys, your fear. And let me just remind you, life is about change. You cannot stop change. You cannot push it. You cannot make it, you know, go away. But guys, you can make a plan B, or maybe even plan C. You have big, powerful empathy abilities. You want to help so many people. Obviously, you are very active in any kind of charity type of a work. And guys, you are very compassionate, you know. Nobody can come even close to you when it comes to magnanimity. Simply want to help, you know, and you can't emotionally withdraw yourself from people who suffer, okay? But also, guys, I can see big sense of, you know, being, you know, guilty, because, you know, you have a lot of beautiful things and maybe so many people do not have. But guys, we all need to struggle for little piece of bread. So live your life, help if you can, but try not to exaggerate, because you tend to do that. Okay, Pisces. So now let me talk only about love, whether you are man or woman, single or attached. Let me see the very first message, what you need to hear or see. Maybe, guys, this will help. Move! This is beautiful. So, guys, you can see beautiful, big red heart. You can see two hands bowing. Guys, can you see? Knotting the tie. Can I say that? Knotting the tie. Okay, never mind. So, guys, this is love offer. This is your partner who loves you. But, you know, sometimes you can be like, you know, aloof. Your partner wants to wake you up. Your partner is from inside, you know, screaming, do you love me? Do you still love me? Do you still need me? I love you. Do you even see me? Guys, I just explained to you, you tend to take, you know, care of so many things, you know, and people, and sometimes you forget about people who are closest to you. So your partner is screaming, give me more love, give me more attention, please see me, I need you, I, which is standing in front of you. So your partner will recognize, basically you need to recognize this more affection that your partner probably need from you. So honey, move towards your partner, come closer and closer, kiss your partner, hug your partner, and show, you know, love to your partner, because your partner is thirsty of your love. Guys, if you're single, let me see, oh my, Five of Cups, ooh, Pisces, ay, you just destroyed someone else's heart. Oh my, you rejected someone. Oh, whoa. What about empathy, Pisces? You know, I talked like 10 minutes about empathy, you know. You destroyed someone else's heart, unintentionally, or maybe intentionally, guys. You know, I do not know. Probably completely unintentionally. You see, guys, you know, there is a person in your life who is so deeply in love with you. Maybe this person can't approach. Maybe you reject the person. Maybe this is your ex. And probably it is for so many guys of you. Scorpio, could be Cancer, could be Leo, could be Capricorn, could be Taurus. You rejected someone and you destroyed this person. You simply destroyed this person. I mean, guys, you know, maybe you are simply attached and maybe this person came on you saying, you know, I want you. And maybe you reply, honey, I'm not on the market. I'm not available, you know. Still, you know, this person is in such a pain, in such a mourning because of you. This person is still at reach of your hand. But guys, if you are happily ever after in a relationship with someone else, of course, you do not want this person to be with you. Okay, so King of Swords just popped up. Why? I don't know. Some big decision. Somebody will declare something, kind of, you know, please take me in. Please take me back. Please forgive me. Can we talk? Somebody will send you a message. Somebody will even try to fight for you, but kind of you are not interested anymore. Still, emotionally, guys, you are involved. For some of you, this is an Aquarian, and especially one Libra or Gemini is still inquiring about you. If you're single, guys, this person is inquiring about you, who you are, why you're so aloof, why it's so very hard to approach to this Pisces, whether you are man or woman, you know. So someone have like a serious intention, but you simply do not see this person, you know. I mean, maybe you see this person like with your physical eye, but this person want to approach through the eyes of love, you know. So guys, you know, it's very hard, you know, sometimes, you know, to see who fancy us, you know, because, you know, this person is acting like a ghost, you know, probably very often in your surrounding, in your environment, but this person is for now silent. Why? Because you look unapproachable, honey. That's why. And maybe some of you are in mourning because of your ex. Okay, communication is improving, and thank you, Lord. Communication is improving. Probably after this video, you will understand what even I said. There is a person watching me, and then probably you will remember. Then you will turn your attitude like for 180 degree, and you will start communicating because probably you will recognize who this person is. Your current partner, just remember, needs you every single day more and more because you tend to do for everybody else so many things. And, you know, you tend to forget about your partner. Major kind of the magician is saying, more fun. Guys, we are in a Leo season. So what the heck, you know? You can't cry all day long. Go out and mingle with people. Very interesting group of people, or one person, very interesting, is now in your life, you know? So start talking, exchanging your wishes, your hopes, your dreams. Because this magician, he can make any desire, any wish of yours, he can or she can make a reality for you. So guys, in the next weeks, you are basically much more powerful spiritually and intellectually and emotionally than basically you do not know. You do not recognize your power, but thank the Lord, other people see that in you. And there you go, Pisces. I really think this is a very powerful and beautiful reading. Put your comments. Okay, so please share this video with your friends, like this video, and subscribe on my channel. God bless.